Moving on, we have Ankur who's called in from Delhi. Ankur, how can we help you?
Hello.
Yes, Ankur. Tell us, how can we help you?
Can I proceed with my question?
Please do.
Ma'am, my father is a senior citizen with no income for the last 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And he has sold a property in Calcutta for 21 lakhs. But the market value of the property was 45 lakhs.
Okay.
We came to know later on. So I just want to know, since he is a senior citizen with no income and there has a capital loss which has happened. We consulted the income tax lawyer. He said there is a capital tax loss which has happened and you can carry it forward. My question is very simple. Do my father need to file a return for this loss or does he need to sit and wait?
Absolutely, he has to file a return. Without filing a return, first of all, whether it is a gain or a loss cannot be determined by the tax department. Even if it is a loss and he has to carry it forward, he needs to file a tax return on time. If he files the return late, then he will lose that opportunity. So therefore, filing the return is absolutely must. And just for your information, since you have said that the market value of the property is higher than the actual transaction value, as per Section 50C of the Income Tax Act, he will be taxed on capital gains, not at the agreement value, but at the market value, which I am presuming that is determined as per the valuation rules or the ready reckoner value.
You know, this is something that is going to come to Pankaj. Now, like he said, he sold the flat for 21 lakh. Now, the market value as per ready reckoner rates is 42 lakhs, which is double what he's actually got for the flat.
That's right.
But he will have to pay the difference because of the way the rules have been structured. You pay whatever is higher.
Yes.
In which case, in this case, it is the ready reckoner rate. So he has to pay capital gains tax on that.
That's
but
right.
Technically, he's at a loss. Isn't there, some kind of justice that he can seek? Go and tell the tax department that, look,
unless,
here are the papers. I'm at a loss. Why should I pay this tax?
Unless somebody questions the valuation rules or the reckoner rule, the method of determining the value as per the ready reckoner. Because according to me, that also is a very arbitrary way. Or method, because in the same area, you have the same rates and
right.
The rates
I believe Ankur wanted to ask another question. Ankur, go on.
Ma'am, just one question. Capital loss has happened. In that case also, do we need to pay tax? Because
yes.
Tax is only paid in case of capital gain, not in capital loss.
No. Filing a return, your question was whether you are supposed to file a return.
Yes.
You have to file the return, whether it's a loss or profit. Then you file the return accordingly, do your computation. The income tax officer will decide whether it is a loss or a gain.
Right. The income tax officer will decide. But Ankur, let me make one thing very clear over here. The laws say that, you need to pay capital gains tax on either the market value of the flat or on the agreement value of the flat, whichever is higher. Now, in your case, unfortunately, the market value is much far, far higher than the sale price, than the price at which you've sold the flat. However, you will have to pay, you will have to take that into consideration when you pay tax. You will have to pay capital gains tax on the 45 lakhs, and not the 21 lakh rupees at which you sold the flat. Now, that is how the law is structured. And like Pankaj said, that is something that is arbitrary in the law. And somebody actually needs to challenge that.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.